This UC Davis lab has become Brian Mujaya's home away from home.
Every single piece of research essentially is done in this room.
He's here almost every day.
So I'm a second year PhD student.
Using his brain cells.
Chemical engineering.
For the future.
I try to be.
As much as I can.
And that future includes using meat cells to make more meat.
Not a lot of schools have this specific resources dedicated to cultivated meat.
What's happening in this lab is technical stuff. Really difficult to understand.
In our case, we're looking at muscle cells, so beef muscle cells.
But the reason why it's happening isn't difficult to understand at all.
The projection is by 25 years from now, due to growing world population and a changing diet, especially in developing countries, there's going to be a need for anywhere from 50% more meat to 100% more meat. And there's already a huge amount of meat produced in the world, so potentially having to double that means that we're going to have to find new ways of creating meat.
So in its basic form, researchers at UC Davis are growing meat cells and new ones and doing it in a large quantity.
Yeah, essentially we're trying to duplicate the cells as many times as we can while controlling certain properties like taste, nutrition.
Those cells would grow in gigantic fermenters, hard to envision, but the beef cells would be all rounded together to create a hamburger or even a steak.
This is really the beginning for cultivated meat.
Professor David Block, who leads the team, believes within 15 years, cultivated meat will be found in every grocery store. But there are obstacles that could stand in its way, including consistency.
It's one thing to create a hamburger out of cow cell. It's another thing to create a perfectly marbled steak. And doing that large scale is still, the details haven't been worked out.
Cost is going to be another big issue. Companies producing cultivated meat need to be on par with its traditional counterparts.
It's got to be about the same price. If it's twice as expensive and not twice as good, people aren't going to buy it.
Vacuum suctioning the liquid out.
There is still a lot of work to be done before cultivated meats hit mainstream markets. But for students like Mujaya, the future is the present.
Not being able to feed the world is a really big issue that we have to deal with, and the potentials that cultivated meat offers really is quite unlike any other product we've seen before.
For photojournalist Victor Nieto, Jason Marks, KCRA3 News.
Even though it may be years before you find cultivated beef in grocery stores, last year the Department of Agriculture approved the sale of lab-grown chicken by a handful of companies. Yeah.